So as Andy said, the third in my series, and just to give you a little background on the series, about the time that President Obama had been elected, there was a lot of talk about race relations. And one of my favorite topics in the world of George Washington was the relationship that the most powerful and most popular man in the world at one point, George Washington, relationship that he had with a man that he owned, right? Worthy of his attention when he writes his will on July 9th of 1799, he's in perfect health. He writes that all the slaves that he owned in his own right after the death of his wife will receive their freedom. They're not free until Martha's dead. But essentially hands Martha a t-shirt with a big target on the back of it.
Yeah, right.
Right? Yeah. And then he writes a lot of complicated reasons as to why he doesn't want these people freed. Next paragraph, with the exception of my mulatto servant William, in parentheses, calling himself William Lee. George Washington is an aristocrat. He does not refer to slaves using two names, only one name. Slaves don't have last names. I don't call him William Lee. He calls himself William Lee, right? Due to his attachment to me, paraphrase, his attachment to me and service to me during the Revolutionary War, I grant him immediate freedom. So he's freed immediately, and he lives the rest of his life at Mount Vernon. It's a wonderful story, at least I think it is. They spend every waking moment of the American Revolution, all 8 years of the Revolutionary War, at each other's side, in combat, in conference, whatever the case might be. Virtually every important biography on Washington talks about this relationship. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the only book written on the topic as told from Billy's perspective, right? So I struggled with how the story was going to be told. Does Washington tell it? Does a third person tell the story? And unwittingly, by selecting Billy to tell that story, I broke ground. It's never been done from that perspective before. Number one. Number two, for myself, unwittingly, I was creating a series of life with Washington, seen through the eyes of people that knew him well.